Hi, I'm Mark Fisher, former president here of Dwyer Instruments LLC. Been with the company for about 35 years and transferring into a role of corporate advisor going forward. Was able to serve the company in many different capacities, coming out of school, working as an inside sales engineer and managing global sales, marketing, product management functions, also the engineering and quality control. Had 35 years with a great set of people, and we achieved some amazing things. Along the way, my wife that I met at college, we were able to have four kids, and we've got two grandkids on the way, so we're really exciting in this transition as we continue to go forward. But overall, the organization's in tremendous hands, and I'm looking forward to the great things that we're accomplishing going forward.
I'm Naoto Mizuta. I have the great honor of succeeding Mark as the new president of Dwyer and Omega. I currently live in Boston with my wife and three daughters, but I spent most of my life growing up in Chicago. I have over 26 years of experience in the technology manufacturing space, dealing with a variety of different products from board level components and materials, different go-to-market approaches, direct and distribution, variety of different industries from consumer electronics, automotive, medical, and industrial. A variety of different geographies, really ranging across North America, Asia, and Europe. Most recently, I was head of the industrial business unit at Mizuta, which is a sensor manufacturer based in Massachusetts. And I'm very much looking forward to taking the helm here at Dwyer Omega and continuing on this great tradition.
So the enduring qualities that we need to adhere to going forward are pertaining to our core values of the organization. For those of you that may be fairly new, I think it's important to understand where our core values came from. It's not something that we aspired as a management team, but something that was created within the organization. Very specifically, going back 4 to 5 years, we had groups of 20, I think either 3 or 4, that included folks in the plants. And functional departments where we came up with these. And it was a long process, but we came up with these because it truly identified, at least we felt it truly identified who we are. And the three core values are innovation, people excellence, and spirit of winning. I feel strongly that if we continue to work on those and hone those and have everybody live those core values out, that organization will continue to rise to unprecedented levels of success.
So I remember the first time that I was in a Dwyer facility, and I was here during my interview process, actually in Mark's office. And at that time, both obviously Dwyer is interviewing me and trying to assess whether I'm qualified, but it's the same time I'm looking at Dwyer and wondering if this is a place that I want to spend the next part of my career. And I look over and I see the core values poster on the wall, and I saw those three that Mark just mentioned that really resonated with me. I said, this is a kind of place that has the same values that I have in business and in personal life. So I really felt comfortable that this was a good place for me to be. When we talk about the spirit of winning and delivering on customer, creating customer value, or innovation, and the fact that our technology is going to continue to be our differentiator in the market, and of course the fact that culture always eats strategy for breakfast, and it's that our people that make everything work in the organization. So having those three really line up is a very basis for what Dwyer represents, I think is a very important part of why I decided that this was the next place for me to be as well.
So what do I see happening in the next 5 years? Well, I think if we look at what's happened in the last year, I think that's a pretty good indicator of what's going to happen here in the next 5 years. And I look at the change we've made, especially with the recent acquisition of Omega. And just looking at our organization, we've doubled in size here in a year, which is pretty amazing. And then striving to achieve long-term goals as a leader, looking at ourselves, not what we're going to do 1 to 2 years down the road, but what we pause this organization looking for 10 years. And taking the stretch and taking the chance and challenging our people and the industry for that matter, and who we feel that Dwyer can truly be. In 5 years, we're definitely acquired more companies. Globally, we're already viewed as a leader in many different areas, but what we have planned in the acquisitions is just going to cement that and create something that I think all of us will admit in 5 years will be beyond our wildest dreams in terms of what we see today. So you look at many organizations in terms of, you know, where they're at in the world and how they stagnate. And I think what's very interesting here at Dwyer in the next 5 years is a lot of vitality, a lot of imagination. And I think there's a lot of people that dream big. And when you dream big, I think that just simply helps things become a reality and the people here to make it happen. So there's a lot to be excited for. I don't think people should be nervous. I think they should be really, really excited about what the future holds here for the company in the next 5 years.
I agree with Mark. I think that in 5 years, Dwyer and Dwyer Omega combined are going to continue its history of strong growth. I see us getting closer to $1 billion in net revenue in total. I see us being recognized as the leader of sensing and measurement technologies, really helping make the world greener and more connected. I also see Dwyer Omega being recognized as an employer of choice because of our culture and because of the opportunities that growth delivers in terms of career opportunities.
Sure, but I know he's already doing it, so it's I think it's good news for everybody. But there's two simple things you need to look after. You know, one is the customer is the most important thing in this business, and we always have to keep the customer front and center. And the other thing I think Naoto's demonstrated clearly throughout his career is that he's a hands-on person. And he is sensitive in terms of what's going on in the front line of the organization. Any leader needs to be in touch with that. So you know when to pivot and know when to make changes and do things that are intuitive and instinctive. And he certainly has these qualities. So those are the two major things that I carry out and transfer. I'm 100% comfortable with that.
I can say that I'm very humbled at the opportunity to lead Dwyer and Dwyer Omega. I know that I'm filling tremendous shoes and what Mark's done with the organization over his long tenure here. And all I can say is that I'll be doing my best to really add to the story, add to the long history and legacy of Dwyer.